Hey traders, we'll be getting started in just a moment. Please take a minute to read this disclaimer. All right. Good morning, traders, and welcome to this weekly strategy outlook. Today is Monday, November 13th, and I'm Michael Boutros, senior technical strategist here at Forex.com. Pleasure to be with you guys this morning. Febby Generoso's in the house. Denise, good morning to you. Hey, Scott, I see your question there on the euro. We'll definitely hit that. Zoltan Gold is definitely on the menu. Lots to discuss, guys. The markets have been, well, I don't want to say, let me say this, we've seen a really nice rally in broader equity markets. By the way, guys, I'm fighting a cold here from the kids. Like the second the weather changed, everyone got sick. So excuse my my voice might be a little harsh today, but we saw that massive rally in stocks. We're coming into some critical levels. And I know I say that a lot in these webinars, guys, but so many of these setups we're gonna go over today are really, really at major, major levels, specifically oil, which is coming off support, specifically, the pullback that we've seen in the DXY, which is maybe a little bit more upside to go, but still trading at some key levels. So on the menu for today, we're going to hit DXY, Euro, British Pound, Dollar CAD. Okay, are we back? Okay, Citrine, thanks for that. I apologize, guys. I had a little glitch there on my our end. So starting from the top, we're going to take a quick look at DXY. Let's jump right in. So our last update here, this was right into the start of last week. Actually, it was Wednesday of last week. And I wanted to give you guys an update. We had come off of a big support zone, and that was based on slope. Here's what DXY looks like on the weekly charts. Here's our last weekly update here on Forex.com. So this was published a little bit earlier as we were talking about resistance. And that major resistance level, guys, was 107.18. That was defined by the 50% retracement of the drop from last year's high, but also a critical confluence of slope, medium term upslope off the yearly low with this pitchfork had the upper parallel there. Right, the longer dated 2011 original slope series that we've been following for almost a decade, right? Resistance, that was there as well. So we threw up the red flag saying, hey, long side is vulnerable here. This is a big resistance. You'd essentially need a weekly close above 107.18, right? And again, guys, this was published back on October 26th. Here's what it looked like last week on the daily chart, okay? First, here's the weekly, right? We came right into that 107.18 level, massive weekly outside reversal candle took us back below 105.40. And here's a little bit of a bounce higher. To start off the week, here's the potential. This is from 1,000 feet up, right, guys? Ted, feel free to take your snapshot. Okay, Apollo says, Mike, are you projecting charts? My screen is stuck at the disclaimer. Guys, I'm so sorry about the technical issues today. Can I just get another confirmation that we're up with sound and video? We're good. Zoltan, thanks for that. So weekly chart hasn't changed, right? A quick reminder, anyone who's new to the room, there's a camera button at the top of your GoToWebinar screen, or if you want to take a snapshot, feel free to do that of all these charts. But here's the daily, okay? There's that last tag of 107.18. Bottom end of that was 107.07, which was the high day close for the year. Rejection, move lower, right? This move, guys, took out last month's opening range lows. The October opening range never broke. We closed below, then here's this rebound. If that reversal and the outside reversal week that we got a couple of weeks back, if that is the onset of a larger correction within the uptrend, then rallies should be limited essentially to the slope confluence here. On the report last week, I did put 106.67, which is the objective monthly open. But right now that slope convergence comes in just ahead of that. So like, let's say 106.50s. If DXY is still deeper on a correction within this uptrend, that rally would need to hold 106.50, okay? Initial support is 105.63. Here's what it looks like on the near-term chart. No change to any of those levels from last week. Here's a quick side-by-side comparison. We had just rebounded off of downtrend support, looking for a breach of the median line, see if we're gonna go for a tag of that 106.25 level. We actually closed above that level last week and we tested it in overnight trade as support. So initial resistance right into the start of the week, guys, we're looking at 106.25, 106.17. That's the objective October open, not Mike Boutros' opinion or StoneX's opinion, fact. And the objective 618 retracement of decline from last month's high or from that late swing high in October. So initial resistance, bearish invalidation. Okay, if we breach through the objective monthly open at that point, okay, we'd start to look for resumption of the broader uptrend. Till that happens, guys, as you can see here on the medium term charts, we've rebounded off of downtrend support. Here's initial downtrend resistance. Okay, we're still operating under the assumption, that all of these, we're still operating under the assumption that this pullback off of resistance is corrective in nature. We're ultimately looking for a more significant low to fade. But as it stands right now, this rally does look a little bit vulnerable as we get into 106.25. Questions on DXY. We do get core inflation data tomorrow. Headline read supposed to come in at 4.1%. Headline inflation is actually supposed to tick down from 3.7 to 3.3. Don't forget, we also get retail sales later in the week. But those core inflation data tomorrow, that's going to be pretty critical. Remember, at this point, guys, the markets have seen a slowdown in non-farm payrolls or broader employment. They've seen that the inflation data, as far as PCE is concerned, starting to abate. And basically, the bet is becoming more prominent that the Fed is, if not done, maybe another 25. I personally don't think another 25 or so, guys, is going to make a difference. But the point being is that we're essentially reaching terminal, right? And if that's the case, you know, this near-term recovery in the DXY still might be short-lived. So just use caution there. 106.67 is bearish invalidation. Now, if we buckle back below 105.63, near-term support here, last week's open, that's not, that's not really important anymore. We don't have to focus about the open, but that same level right here at 105, that's gonna be your break. That'll open up the next decline for a little bit lower of a drop. Now remember, guys, two equal legs have already been essentially popped right here. So the 1618 extension is at 103, below 104. Again, that's neither here nor there. Right now, the focus is whether this recovery fizzles out ahead of that resistance. DXY lower time frames, 4 hours. You got it? Quick snapshot there for you. So that's the DXY. Again, biggest headline event risk this week will be those core inflation data readings tomorrow. So where does this leave us on euro dollar? So that's where things get a little hairy. Here's what euro looked like on our last euro dollar weekly update back on October 24th. We're talking about this recovery off of support, essentially the objective opening range lows for the year, the January low, 104.82, rebounded off that. We highlighted a critical resistance region last week, right here. Objective yearly open, that's 107.05, 38.2 retracement of the yearly range. That's 107.65. Guys, within this zone is also the objective yearly 52-week moving average. We've been here under this region now for 3 weeks. So this is where you could see the potential for, okay, remember 60% of DXY is euro, right? So at this point, if we get a little bit of a pullback here in euro, that might give a little bit of alleviation to the DXY, which is why near term, I still think that threat is for the is for that push higher, but we're looking for possible exhaustion there. Hey, man, great to see you in the room. No worries. Welcome. So we opened the week for a second week. Last week's range, obviously, guys, was pitiful in euro, but we're still holding just below resistance. And that is defined, again, by 107.05, 107.65. This is from 1,000 feet up, our multi-time frame analysis approach. That's the weekly chart. Here's what the daily chart looks like. Okay, now here was the last update on our daily charts here on Forex.com. This was published back on the open of November, on November 1st. And we were talking about this confluent support zone, 105.42, right? Right into the open of November, guys, we pinpointed that level as a critical level. If euro is heading higher, we need to maintain a stance above 105.42. That very day, we closed right into the open of the month again, 105.75. And it was just a straight one-way shot. Now, we faltered right ahead of our major sort of confluence region we were looking for last week, and that was 107.67, 107.65. Remember, on the weekly chart, top end of that range is 107.65. Bottom line, uptrend resistance, failure, we're still constructive above the monthly open. That's 105.75. Initial support, 106.35. So the daily chart, again, comes off uptrend resistance. You can envision a scenario where we go for a test of uptrend support. As it stands right now, that threat for a little bit deeper of a washout remains while below the yearly open, which is 107.05. Here's what it looks like on the intraday chart. And this is what I showed you guys last week. This is the same slope that we're looking at on the daily. I've since added a pitchfork to this advance on the four-hour chart. Here's what it looks like. Here's a quick snapshot of the daily if you need it. And here's the 4 hour. So instead of those two parallels, I'm just working with a pitchfork off the lows here, offset low, high that we made about October 23rd, and then, October 23rd, and then the low that we made on November 1st. The upper parallel literally caught that advance last week. Here we are threatening a break below the median line. So once again, you envision a scenario where you're coming off of uptrend resistance, looking for a tag of uptrend support. Initial support, 106.35, bullish invalidation. Like I said, 105.66, 105.75. That's the 618 of this near-term rally as well. So the levels are well-defined. If you're holding shorts from last week, 106.35 and 105.80s is where you want to start to look. Reduce positioning, definitely bring in your protective stops, right? If you're looking for new exposure, the focus here is for this pullback and whether or not we find support into 106.35 or whether it gets deeper towards 105. But the bottom line is we're looking for downside exhaustion in the euro. Questions? Pretty light on euro data this week, if my memory serves me correct. So can you look for the dollar really drive things here? You get core inflation data. This is the final read for October on the 17th, but don't think that's going to be a major market mover. Okay. All right. Any questions on euro before we move on? We're making good time here. All right. British pound. Next. So sterling's been a very interesting game. The pullback has been much steeper than we were seeing on that euro pullback. But here was the initial game plan for sterling. This thing has been in this range, guys, for a very long time. We've been talking about it for months. This was on October 19th, so nearly a month ago. We were talking about this key range right here above the objective yearly open. That's right here at 120.84. The yearly low week close, resistance 23.15, all the way up into that January high week close, which is 23.97. Okay, so nearly a month out, guys, and we're still in this range. Yes, we've broken descending channel resistance, but the range highs held resistance. What is 23.15, 23.97? It's the 618 retracement of the yearly range objective, not Mike Boutros' opinion, fact. The January high day close, fact. The objective yearly moving average, 52-week moving average, fact, right? We haven't closed above that zone yet. Here's what it looks like on a close basis. So again, breakout of a multi-month downtrend, failing at lateral resistance, where does that leave us? Well, we're still on the lookout for possible downside exhaustion. Alex says Euro bullish inval. So Euro bullish inval is going to be at the monthly open, right? I think we went over that, Alex. Maybe we missed it. So Euro bullish inval is going to be right here at 105.75. It's the objective monthly open would necessitate a break below that uptrend. Make sense? British pound on the daily looks like this, okay? Very similar structure for the upslope and the breakout of that multi-month downtrend, just like in Euro, right? No change to any of those levels. Here's our update on British pound. This one was published last week, if I'm not mistaken, Tuesday of last week. As we were looking at this breakout, we noted that we had turned right ahead of confluence resistance, 24.59, again, the December high. This is the 200-day moving average, right? So we were looking for exhaustion on the downside ahead of the monthly open. I still think that's the game plan. So you got the buckle below the median line. That dropped into the 25% parallel. We're seeing some support here. Again, you know, I'm looking for confirmation of exhaustion low. It's either a rally back through the median line, in which case you're looking for a resumption, or it's a drop back into monthly open and you're looking for downside exhaustion. That's the focus for the British pound into the start of the week. Now you do get employment data on tap tomorrow, which could offer a little bit of a shake, but really it's very similar to the game plan that we're looking at with the euro. As we get deeper, here's what it looks like on the 4-hour chart. Again, that same pitchfork that we used last week, right? No change. We buckle below the median line. There's support at the 25% parallel. We're looking exhaustion off of one of these two levels. Was that it on Friday? I don't know, right? We have no idea. The signal would be either the breach above the median line, which puts resumption, or like I said, one last washout towards the November open. I'd want to see a larger defense for the British pound there. Any questions on sterling? Going once, going twice. All right. So that's British pound, right? The juicy stuff comes in the commodity, so we'll get there soon. I see your question there. Yeah. Oil's huge. I really can't stress it enough. We'll go in that in a moment. So that's the British pound. Next up is dollar CAD. So dollar CAD is the one, I mean, aside from the yen, which you guys know how I feel about the yen, but the dollar CAD is the one where, like, I feel like there's the most risk, okay? Here was our last update on the British pound here on Forex.com. The weekly chart was published. This was back on October 20th, and the focus was on this major resistance confluence at 137, basically 136.97. 786 retracement of the yearly range. Multi-year trend resistance. Here's what that pitchfork looks like, guys. It's off the pitchfork from 2020. Tested again last year. Tested again in February, March of this year. So we got the breakout, okay? And where did the breakout falter? Right into the 2022 high week close, right here, 38.81. It's exactly where we reversed. Now, if you recall, guys, that week was an outside weekly reversal. For anyone who's new to the room, when the candle takes out the previous day's highs and closes below the previous day's lows, this outside reversal is oftentimes a signal for exhaustion. So that shifted our focus to look, this could be a false break scenario of a break of this multi-year trend line, in which case scenario, if we close back below the yearly open, Toronto Mo, This thing could fall apart really quick. Well, last week we defended and popped back through. So where does that leave us? On face value, if we're to look at this from a disciplinary technical approach, this looks like a breach of trend resistance, possible test of support, and then rebound, which puts the emphasis, guys, right now on a break of this single weekly range from October 30th. That's the only thing I'm looking for guidance on Dollarcat, is a break of this candle, a break of this weekly candle range. It's 138.81 resistance. Basically, you're looking at like 136.60 support. Okay, so we're making these assumptions and we're making this assertion from the weekly chart. Now, if we drill down, and by the way, here's momentum, right at 60. So momentum is still in favor of the bulls, but you're not like crazy overbought where you're starting to look like, okay, you know, there's a lot more to go here. Just be cautious, right? Here's what dollar CAD looks like on the daily chart. And here was our last update on the daily chart here on forex.com. This was published back on October 30th, right into the close of the month. We had faltered already into 38.81, and we were looking to see if we can find support off one of these two levels. If the advance off the July low is to remain viable, we cited 36.80s, September high day close, as our bullish inbound. Now, we actually did get a little below that. Here's 36.80. We did break below that, but look where the low faltered, right at slope support. So guys, when I highlight these on the charts, it's telling you when that level is important in time, right? So 36.89 would have been really important if we were out here, basically a couple days early. We dropped early, rather. So went for a tag of trend support. Here's the recovery. The monthly opening range is preserved. We're now testing right into the open of the week, uptrend resistance. Key resistance, 38.81. The monthly open comes in right below that, 38.74, I think is what it comes in at. What is it? 38.74, damn, nasty. All right, cool. So the levels are well-defined, and this is what the focus is heading into the start of the week. Does dollar CAD exhaust into 38.80? If we get a weekly close, a daily close, I'm even willing to accept on this one. We're looking for resumption for 39.90. But as long as we stay below this, that threat is for, again, that pullback in dollar CAD. Here's what it looks like on the intraday chart. Pretty clean as far as this basic channel formation off the lows, guys. This is back from the July lows. Here's the median line buy sector. Right? Breach, support, break, acceleration on every single pivot along that median line. Resistance. Look for a reaction here right into the start of the week. Core inflation data out of Canada comes out next week. So as far as this week is concerned, you're really limited. There's not much CAD data on tap. All right. Questions on dollar CAD? No, just as a disclaimer, no positions on this for me. I've just been tracking it like a hawk, but I'm really interested to see how this one specifically opens the week. I think it might be a tell. Keep an eye on this one. All right, that's dollar CAD. Dollar yen. I don't really have much to say here, but I just wanted to highlight to you guys that weekly chart I published last week, it's insane. It's literally the same chart. And guys, you know me, I'm a full believer in full transparency. So on every single one of my reports, you can click on in the first paragraph, the link to the previous report to see how's Mike Boutros been faring. Maybe he's completely off his noggin with this one and we're wrong. Here was the update, guys, back from October 18th. We pivoted above 47.60, 48.70. This was a big zone that we were talking about for months. Once that broke, we stayed constructive above it, but man, that thing fell into a tight range for weeks. The levels don't change. We're now testing resistance into the 152 handle. That represents the 1989 high and the 1986 low. It is also the region where last year's rally faltered. We're there right now. Okay, you literally need to go back in historic price action to find those levels. And you know, you can trust me on that when I did it. These are the levels. So Now, a couple of things to take note on a move like this, right? Before you start getting cute and you start saying, oh, well, this is a resistance, and so we must be looking for exhaustion here. Hold your horses. Momentum is an overbought condition on the weekly standpoint. This is when the market has the most push. Remember, I always remind you guys this, it's the pullback below 70 that is going to be your signal for a turn in momentum. As long as the RSI oscillator, this is just a 14 basic RSI oscillator, is above 70, that's actually when the momentum has the most thrust. Don't take my word for it. Here's previous price action. The entire time we're in overbought, the market is ripping. So that's one reason I'm not looking to get cute on this, because the momentum's in favor of the bulls right now. Look at it on the daily chart. Here's dollar yen. Okay. 2022 high, again, those reference points I noted, 152, gonna take you on to the 1986 and 1989 swings, right? The only thing I wanted to highlight here, and the most exciting thing for me on this specific trade, guys, is that the monthly opening range is preserved right below resistance. Remember, monthly opening range, you're looking for the market to set a high, low, high, or a low, high, low early in the month. And then you look for a breakout of that to give you the extremes. So if we break the monthly opening range to the upside, you look for that late month high. If you break the monthly opening range to the downside, look for that late month low. We're checking resistance right here, right now, today. Watch 152 on the close. Denise says, yep, this one's looking to make a new high. Yeah, if this breaches, guys, by the way, we got to go back to the weekly chart. The next level up is going to be 154. That's the 227. I know it's probably going to perk up some ears. You guys don't often see that here on the Fib retracements, but it's just another derivation of the key 618 ratio. And that essentially takes you back into 154 on the upside. Just higher is going to be basic upslope resistance. So if we do manage to close a week above 152, the next major upside level doesn't come in until another 200 pips from a technical standpoint. Does that make sense? All right. Denise says, makes sense. Right on. Always good to see you in the room. All right. So that is dollar yen, all three time frames. You know, monthly opening range is set, testing resistance. Here's your monthly opening. We're actually right above the monthly open right now, but watch that 52 on a close basis. Last but not least, from the FX standpoint, is Aussie. And who was asking about this earlier? Yeah, someone was asking about Aussie earlier. I'm sorry, there's a lot of questions here, guys. So instead of wasting time trying to find it, I'm going to jump right in. Here's what Aussie looks like on the weekly charts. So typically, this asset is one of my favorite setups. But as you guys know, the last couple of weeks have just not really been offering much. Here's Aussie from our last update here on Forex.com. This was published back on November 3rd, right into the open of the month. We had made that big, big rebound off of downtrend support. And then last week, right back. Now, if you read this report, guys, the bullish invalidation level I wrote was right here at 63.34. The low week close for the year. Guys, the low last week was right there. Literally, the low is 63.38. Okay. So what does that mean? Does that mean we should be looking for a settling here? This support needs to hold. That's where we drill down deeper. So all I have to say on the Aussie from the weekly charts is watch 63.35. If we close below the low week close, you're likely to see that resumptive move for the broader downtrend. And that takes you down to 62. 62 is two equal legs off this year's high. It's also the 2022 low week close. The low was registered this week. The close of that session was right there. And it's also the objective 2008 swing, low close. So we put to a line chart, boom. So the levels are really well-defined in Aussie. My only problem is like this thing held support last week exactly where it should. but you didn't get much of a rebound. Here's what it looks like on the daily chart. Right? Like, what is that? Here's the monthly open. You rock it. Trying to break through the May low day close. You actually had a close above it. Next day, 3 day decline, 4 day decline, right back into the monthly open. So look, if this breakout is legit, if the breakout of the July downtrend was legit last month, losses need to be limited by this zone. That's all I have to say. So from a trading standpoint here, it's difficult to get a fix on a new position. Here's what the 4 hour chart looks like. And I think I showed you guys this last week and we highlighted, all right, if this immediate advance has more, let's see if we can find support ahead of 64. That broke and just tumbled. Here's the November open. So before I start saying there's a near-term low registered, I would need to either get back above that slope, or like I said, if we find one last settle back towards that key support zone to 63, possibility that we get another exhaustive low there. But I'm neutral here on Aussie, guys. This one's tricky. This one's tricky. All else, right, held constant, the monthly opening range is preserved. We'll be looking for a breakout there to give us some guidance on Aussie. Any questions there? I wish I had more conviction for you on this, guys, as I always do, but I just don't think we have it there. Keep an eye on the 15th. We do get employment out of Australia. Might be something that roils in a market a little bit, but mostly dollar should be driving. Yes, Alex, before we jump into the comm block, which is next, here's what the 10-year yields look like first from the weekly charts, and then we'll drill down a little bit deeper, but just a basic overview. Remember, 5%, that big psychological barrier pulled back. This is some interesting slope action. These parallels, guys, are all derived from the advance off the 2020 low. So this is a parallel off that swing high in 2021. Another parallel off the swing highs from 2019, and you could see resistance, acceleration, resistance, acceleration, support. If yields have quote unquote topped, I would need a close below 428, this zone right here. 432, 428. So I don't think the pullback is necessarily completed. Again, that's not a trade recommendation from forex.com or StoneX, guys. This is my humble opinion with the technicals suggesting here. If this is a corrective move within the broader uptrend, I'd be looking for that last washout wave lower. And again, both slope support off the lows from April and the longer-term slope support here in blue off the lows from December of last year, one touch, two touch, three touch, four touch, right? Converges on that pivot on the 618 retracement. This is the decline off the highs from 1999, or it's the 2000 high actually. But you get the picture. Okay, so that's the weekly chart from 1,000 feet up. If we drill down even deeper on the 10-year, here's what the daily chart looks like. A pitchfork off the highs here has been actually calling the decline pretty decent, right? So breach back above the median line throws this thrust into focus. So it's either exhaustion here or exhaustion here, bearish invalidation 481 for the near term yield outlook. Okay, even if it rallies this high, it's still within the confines of the broader decline off of the monthly highs, and it will have completed a 618, excuse me, retracement off the lows. So moral of the story, from a technical standpoint, I'm basically looking for topside exhaustion on yields. Okay, well below 480, that's my level in the 10-year. Now the 2-year, maybe not quite as clean, but let me tack on a quick retracement here. You can see that the 618 is upcoming right here at 509, just above the five handle. Forget that. High day reversal close. 516. So something like this. This would be your bearish invalidation level. High day close. Okay. Quick outlook there on what yields are doing. And again, I've just been watching this ongoing, the 10-2 spread, which a lot of people tend to focus on. We were within striking distance, 14 basis points of 12 basis points of striking distance of going back to new to baseline here, but we didn't quite get it. So I think the yield story might calm down a little this week. Watch tomorrow's inflation data, and if we get any volatility on that, a lot of people are looking at that. All right, that leaves us commodities and stocks, and we got a lot of time to do it. So let's jump right in. First things first, gold. So for gold, here's what it looks like on the weekly chart. Whoops, wrong charts. And here was our last update on gold here on forex.com. We published this one back on Friday, right to the close of the week. And I just wanted to give you guys an update on the near-term picture. Here's what the last longer-term technical charts look like for the weekly chart on gold. This was published way back. This was back in 25th of last month. But just wanted to highlight the rally ripped into the 2022 high we closed. That's 1988. We did get multiple weekly closes above, but we just couldn't get any follow-through, right? So on that breakout, that was sort of our line in the sand, said if we get a close above this, we're looking for that resumptive move to 2034. Didn't work. We got the close above it, but it quickly faltered, right? And here's gold just completely falling apart, 38.2 retracement at advance. Listen, very tightly here. There was a lot of technical significance to this three-week stretch off the lows. If the breakout of the May downtrend is legit, gold would need to find a low ahead of 1886, 1891, this zone right here. Okay. Now, that might not help you, be very have strong conviction on this trade, but there's levels are just really well defined. And this, I think we're going to be looking closely at the dollar to see whether we get that larger pullback in gold, larger rally in the dollar, which would be a headwind, right? So 1933, that's support right here, right now to the start of the week. Below that, the 52-week moving average is 1918. And then again, the 618 of the rally, the 2021 high week reversal close, huge pivot in price. That gives you an 1886, 1891. We're looking for a low ahead of this zone if gold is heading higher. Okay. Joy, I will look at silver for you in a moment. I actually haven't checked that out this week. Thanks for asking. Yeah, we'll look. But before we do, that's a weekly chart from a, so from 1,000 feet up, guys, the levels are well defined as far as support is concerned. Well, Mike, how do we know when the low is in? Well, here's what it looks like on the daily chart. Okay. Okay, and here was the last update here on forex.com. Again, this was published on Friday of last week. And what I wanted to highlight was two levels. First was 1933. Like I said, we're there now. Aside from the fact of what we just showed you on the weekly chart, also the 200-day moving average is also right here, right now, today, support. So I'm looking for inflection here. If we were to see a downside break, it would keep the bearish bias intact. Again, key support 1877, 1886. As far as a close above or what would invalidate the downside bias, initial resistance is 1969. Monthly open is right here at 1983. But unfortunately, it has to be this zone right here. The November high day close, the April. For April 14th reversal close, major pivot in price. That's still key resistance and near-term bearish invalidation. Drill down even deeper. Here's the four-hour chart looks like. Let me take a step back. That's broader bearish invalidation for the medium-term drop. Near-term, whoop, here's what the four-hour looks like, right? This pitchfork off the high, confluence support, July high day close. That's going to be 1969. That's near-term bearish inval. Does that make sense? If we buckle 1933 on a daily close basis, 1909, there's 1886, 18, excuse me, 1886, 1877, key support. But right now, the focus right into the start of the week is what kind of inflection, if any, do we get right here? Denise says, makes sense. Right on. So Joy, you're looking at silver, right? So silver had one of those moves where it was really nice because it was a confluence support zone. But the problem is for literally 4 weeks, we never made the definitive move until last week. And that zone is right here. Former uptrend support, 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 break, resistance, resistance, resistance for 3 weeks before last week finally pulling lower. Add to that the 52-week yearly moving average. Nice pivot in price was right along that slope as well. So it looks like we broke slope support, tested former support as resistance, and the threat is for that kickback still. So this is where for gold, for oil, for silver, excuse me, Denise, or who is this for? Joy. It's more, for me, looks more rangy even than gold is. Here's what silver looks like on the daily chart. Hold on one sec. Could be a slope that's in play. Give me just a moment. I haven't really been taking a look at this. Yeah, I'd probably be working with this. See how this performs here today if that slope is in play. But at the end of the day, this break, sub 2230, right into the start, right into the close of last week, right? Actually, we just defended it as resistance into the open of this week. Does open up the chance for that 2150, 2085. That was huge, guys. These are my favorite, and I show you guys these all the time. My favorite Fibonacci confluences, 100% extension off the high, two equal legs, un, deux, trois, 618 retracement off the low. Confluence zone was with slope. Man, that literally nailed the low last month. So this buckle, unfortunately, does, you know, basically beg for a test of that 2125 level. The only other thing I'd be looking at this on a short-term time frame is just what the 618 of the rally looks like. And we're basically testing that as support right here, right now. Watch this today. All right, Joy, does that help? Hey, Ted says, can I get the daily and month again? Ted, which one are you talking about? Joy says, yes, thanks. You're more than welcome, Joy. Great questions. Ted, which one are you talking about? Silver? You got it? Yep. Okay. This is the 4 hour and the daily. Okay. So that's gold and silver. Last on the commodity block is oil. Now, I really can't stress this enough. You guys know where I stand on oil. You know, we've been looking for this move off the highs to be corrective. And this is what the weekly chart looks like. We've been, you know, beating this drum for a very long time. Here was our last update. On crude oil. When was this? This was October 30th. This was November. Okay, so just wanted to highlight. This was a webinar from last month. We wanted to highlight this key support zone. But first, here's oil on the weekly chart. Okay, this was back from November 2nd. Break back below 83 had us looking for an exhaustive pullback for a corrective move within the confines of the ascent from the yearly low, and that level, the same exact thing I just showed you in silver. 100% extension off the high, 618 retracement off the low, 7560, 7715, critical support for oil. Here we are. I mean, you can't make this stuff up. So while everyone's getting super bearish to the hilt on Friday, screaming, oh my God, oil's gonna go down to $50, we're at support right now. I'm not saying it's not going to break, but all I'm saying is we're at support. This is not where I want to be increasingly bearish. If we were to settle a weekly close sub 75.60, man, we're probably going to see $69. But until we do, we're at support. Guys, we're at support. I can't say it enough. This is huge, right? Close basis, not even close. Intra-week, sure, made a spike, but we're that low held, right at basic trend line support off the yearly low. So all of this information that we just went through has been derived off the weekly charts, right? Levels to keep in focus. If we get a close below 75.60, big, big problem for crude on a weekly basis. Initial resistance on the weekly chart, your 52-week moving average comes in at 78.18. Yearly open is 80.31. Bearish invalidation is 83.28. Okay, that's from the weekly charts. Now, drill down to the daily. It's pretty sexy. 100 off the high, 6.8 off the low, slope support. Okay, in case that wasn't enough, you had a 2018 swing high right into that region as well. It was also a swing high in 2021, specifically on the July rally, some swing lows last year. I mean, I could keep going, guys. This is huge. So, what can we say about this? Here was our update on the webinar last week before the break. And I just wanted to highlight, actually, this was October 30th, before the break. I just wanted to highlight, guys, on the week, on the daily chart. You see how this set up, 83 handle? There it was. Key support, August high day close, the April high day close, rather. Boom, we broke. Looking for the yearly open, looking for critical support into that 75.60, 77.15 level. Here we are, 4 weeks later. 3 weeks later. So we're rebounding off of, no, what are you talking about there? 22 open, Jay? What do you mean? This is the 2023 yearly open. The 2022 yearly open is a little bit lower. It's actually about around that 6.8 retracement. Are you asking or are you telling? Yeah, I'm aware of that. So he's talking, I think he got excited. So yeah, there is the 2020 two yearly open right here at 75.35. Actually, that might be worth keeping an eye out, right? Yeah, let's leave it on there. Why not? It's Jay who said it is Jay. Man, Jay is like one of our best pupils here in the room. This guy really pulls out the random retracements and the opens. I love it, Jay. Keep it up, brother. So yeah, that even adds, you know, a cherry on top, guys. This is a massively important support zone. We have to watch what happens here on a weekly close basis. Anything sub 75.35, 75.60, you're basically in big trouble for oil. Till it does, we're rebounding off of uptrend support. Now, the only thing that would put me back on the constructive path, like I said, if we pop through the yearly open, it's 80.31, that would necessitate a break through the median line of this near-term descending structure. In that case, it would shift the medium-term focus higher. But longer term, we're not on the resumptive path until we clear like 83.25. That's also the objective monthly opening range highs. So in and of itself, that would be a signal, again, that would put the bulls back in control for the upside here in crude oil. Loving it, guys. This is huge support. Watch this major inflection zone into 75.60, 75.30. Jay, thanks for that level. Love it. I feel like I knew that and I removed it months ago just because there was too many. I try to keep the charts as clean as possible just so we don't lose guys who might be a little bit newer to the strategy here. But hey, I love the confluence zones. Okay, so guys, that's gold and oil in a nutshell. Oil being the more interested of the two, basically coming into a huge area of near-term support. Okay, got about 10 minutes left, and we'll take a quick look at what the equity board looks like. Here's the S&P 500. Another one, guys, where we are at a critical resistance zone. Again, don't take my word for anything, okay? Here was our last update. This was in last week's webinar, November 6th, right? The focus was, guys, S&P 500, big, big resistance, 44.17, 44.16. That's the big zone. We had a pivot there at the August low day close. That was 43.65, excuse me. Even if you got a pivot lower, we noted a constructive bias above 43. Big zone of resistance right here, 44.17, 44.16. Here's what the S&P 500 looks like now. Okay. So before I take you back to the side-by-side comparison of the daily chart on the S&P, here's the weekly chart. This is just the objective swing highs from October. Forget that. Really, the focus is basic slope resistance, a three-point touch. We're testing resistance right here, right now. Now, this is from, again, a weekly chart, 1,000 feet up. Doesn't really tell us much, Mike. What the hell am I supposed to do into the open? Here's what it looks like on the daily, even more compelling evidence. Here's what the daily chart looks like. Side-by-side comparison. Okay, the pullback never materialized much from there. Here's the strike, 618 retracement off the high, 44.17. The June swing high close right here. See this spike, the close of that session was right here. The July low day close was right here on July 10th. That was the low of the month. The close of that session was right here at 44.16, 44.17. Three-point resistance trigger. We're there now, today. One of the additional pieces of evidence that makes me so focused on some sort of inflection of this region here today is the fact that Friday's candle was an outside day reversal, but it wasn't an exhaustive out. It wasn't like an exhaustive outside day reversal. It was an exhausted. It was an outside day reversal higher within an uptrend into resistance. Typically, we look for an outside day reversal lower off resistance for a tell that the exhaustion is in. But when we get the outside day reversal into resistance, guys, that is also a signal that near-term exhaustion may be at hand. Okay, what does RSI look like? Zachary, great question. Here's what RSI looks like. It hasn't really made an assertive push through 60. Remember, in really strong uptrends, we want to find multiple breaches above 60. 70 would be great, but 60, a level that people don't tend to look at. In strong downtrends, we want to see multiple breaks below 40. 30 would be great, but 40, a level that people don't look at. Well, here's a break below 40. Here's a break below 40. Here's a break below 30. Below 40. We haven't cleared 60 on a really like validated basis yet. So guys, that's all to say is that the momentum profile hasn't necessarily shifted in favor of the bulls yet. Obviously, this is one mean V recovery, but we are at resistance. If we close above 44.17, hey guys, that's a breakout, plain and simple. Till we do, we are now testing confluent downtrend resistance, period, exclamation point, end of paragraph. Questions on SPX. So that's from the weekly chart. This is the daily chart. Looks even better on the 4 hour. Here's a pitchfork that we've been working with from last week. Low, high, low. Break the median line, kept the focus higher. Here's the 75% parallel. Resistance, resistance, confluence, resistance. Now, this might very well break, but here's what we want to see. If we are going to break out, that move above 44.17 should be an accelerated pop. Don't take my word for it. Here's what happened when we broke below it. Right? Every time we've come into this level, actually, you've seen accelerated either a rejection or a follow-through run. It's an area of low tolerance. The price doesn't want to sit here, right? So we're looking for inflection right early into the start of the week, early into the start of the session, 44.16, 44.17, key resistance. I put this chart, guys, many, many times on my Twitter handle. By the way, you can always follow me at MBForex. All the charts you see presented here, I disseminate throughout the week, as well as all the reports that are published here on Forex.com. Okay, comment on the megaphone. Ted, yeah, I've been hearing people talk about this possibly being a megaphone type of expansionary. I hate those formations, Ted, to be quite frank with you. I can't even tell you how many people, I'm just not a big, big fan. It very well might be, which would actually suggest this is a time where you want to be a little bit more careful because we're testing the top of that megaphone. But at the end of the day, I'm just focused on this inflection right here. If this is the rebound and a more significant low is in place, this is the pivot that would prove it, okay? It very well may be that a low is in place, in which case pullbacks here you should look for a low ahead of the 200-day moving average, former slope resistance turn support. You should be looking for support ahead of 4260s on any major pullbacks. We need to close above 4417 to mark resumption. Okay, so that's the S&P 500. Here's what the NASDAQ looks like. It's a little bit different because I have us testing former support as resistance in the NDX, basically right here. Just for those of you who are geeks out there, for the Fibonacci guys, it's also the 786 retracement of the decline. But this is the chart I've been showing you guys. Let me take a step back. I'm sorry, I'm out of order. Here's NASDAQ on the weekly chart, right? Massive rebound off of confluence support. It's not the exact same 61800 confluence that I was showing you guys on silver and gold and all that, but this is the longer dated 618 of the 2021 decline. And then this is 100 off the high, so two equal legs. So you can see that it was messy, but we probed it, pull back. Here's the snap. On the weekly chart, this is really the big resistance zone. And point in fact, we actually just pushed through the high week close, which is right here. Okay, so this is a messy chart, but from a weekly chart, basically the impetus here is potential for a push higher. Now, as we drill down deeper, here's the daily. And this is, again, objective stuff, basic trend line support. 2-point touch doesn't really do it. 3-point confirmed, and then we pivoted back below it. That's right here. Again, this 786 is there as well at this point. Get rid of that. Your term resistance. Here's what it looks like on the 4-hour. Just a radical rally, guys. Just a radical rally. Okay, we did technically break downtrend resistance, but this is sort of the first major threshold, the protocol for a push higher. Okay, high day close, high week close from back here in 2021, but the high day close for this year gives us confluence resistance at 15,826, 16,000 basically on the upside if this breaks. So, checking resistance here today. All right, last but not least, can't believe my voice held out the entire session, which is awesome, is the Dow. Here's what the Dow looks like. Obviously, it's been the ugliest of the lot, but nonetheless, we are at resistance, okay? This is the January close high, which obviously you can see has been a major pivot in price. Don't take my word for it. Here it is, okay? And last week's range, if I'm not mistaken, was the largest weekly advance of the year. Twas largest weekly advance of the year, early into the month here, until early into November, and the largest range since the decline that we made right ahead of the yearly lows back in March, right? So these type of extreme signals, guys, can oftentimes be telling at larger market reversals. So that's all to say is that we have a lot of indicators here suggesting that the building base could be a sort of a near-term bottoming process. That said, we're checking resistance here today at 34,000 at 302. Watch today's close. Here's what it looks like on the daily chart. Okay. Big zone, January high day close, August 2022 highs, huge pivot, just higher, 618 retracement of decline. I'm looking for a reaction here today, early in the week. Right here. That's the level I need to be. All right. Bitcoin. Yeah, I'll take a look at Bitcoin for your run. Here's what it looks like, man. So any questions here on the DAO before we move off? So Bitcoin did break a big resistance zone. In fact, on the last webinar last week, I did also put a Bitcoin chart for you guys because I wanted to highlight this major, major level. And this level was 35,000 to 35,758, a 38.2 retracement from the decline off the record high. A 618 extension from the ascent off of the lows from last year, boom, and uptrend resistance. So look, as I always tell you, a breach of uptrend resistance can oftentimes be the largest part of the rally. So I'm really interested to see how this actually opens up the week. It ripped higher. It got as high as like 38,000 guys, and then it actually pulled way back below. We did settle the week above. So from a technical standpoint, I do have to, as per our discipline, look at this as a potential breakout in Bitcoin. Now, that would mean losses would need to be governed by this zone right here. And that zone is basically the objective monthly open, 34.5 something. 34.549. Okay, that's the objective monthly open, not my Boutros' opinion, not Forex.com or StoneX, that's fact. So that converges on the 618 median line here. That's my near-term sort of line in the sand. If we cut back below that, it would suggest that this was a false breakout type of play. As long as we maintain stance above 35,000, I do think that you need to treat this as a larger breakout, at least from the evidence that we have right now, right? Does that make sense, Ron? I know it's got a lot of headlines last week, a lot of headlines, and justifiably so. Into this week, we have to maintain above 35,000 if this is heading higher. Okay, guys, as always, that takes us over on time. Thanks for coping with me. I hope my voice wasn't too hard to bear today, and I do apologize about the technical issues that we had earlier. Best of luck trading this guy. Look, this week, guys, look, the inflation data tomorrow is going to be most important thing. Keep an eye on that. Again, retail sales actually later in the week is supposed to show a contraction for the US. So that's one other thing I'd keep an eye on as we get into the latter part of this week. And we will pick things up next week, hopefully in a healthier vibe. But till then, best of luck trading, guys. Thank you so much, Ron. I appreciate your analysis. Wonderful webinar, Jay, Roland, Denise. This webinar wouldn't be as fun without y'all. So thank you so much, Anna. Have a great week. I'll check you guys on Monday. Cheers.